Koala populations have been hit hard by the bushfires. So news that dozens of koalas have been killed in a rogue logging operation has Australians seeing red. And a warning, this story contains confronting images.
This is all that's left. Survivors clinging to the few remaining trees after a wave of destruction. Just a few months ago, the koala population was thriving at this blue gum plantation near Cape Bridgewater in Victoria. Now their bodies lie in waste piles of logged trees.
It was absolutely horrifying to see this loss of life and in the manner that it's occurred.
Late last year, logging company Southwest Fibre was contracted to remove trees from the 60-hectare property, and they claimed they left the required amount of trees for the koalas to survive.
We fully protected the koala population that was there, and we advised the landowner of the number of koalas on that property when we handed back the property.
But it's alleged last week the landowner cleared the remaining trees.
Look at the destruction that they've done. And there's koalas lying there dead. Mothers killed and only little babies.
The surviving koalas are now on the brink of starvation. Today, vets are working to save as many as possible, but the death toll is rising.
We're looking at least 40 animals at this stage. We expect that number to increase.
Helen Oakley uncovered the site and exposed the carnage.
I was walking the rows of the bulldozed plantations. I was finding dead koalas. I found live koalas with broken arms. It was just a terrible stench coming from the rows.
And it's left many wondering how the hell this could have happened.
At a time when our native wildlife are under so much pressure from the fires, this is an absolutely horrendous thing to have done.
The Victorian government's investigating the massacre, threatening swift and severe action.
We won't leave a stone unturned here. The investigation is underway, but what we know so far, of course, is very heartbreaking.
Under the Wildlife Act, killing, harassing or disturbing wildlife can attract a penalty of up to $8,000 and an additional fine of more than $800 per head of wildlife.
Yeah. What's happened here is wrong. It shouldn't have happened. Let's establish the facts. If there's any offences have been committed, then that investigation is all about getting to the truth and then taking action on it.
The property involved has been declared a crime scene. While the loggers point the finger at the landowners, they claim it's not the big hoo-ha it's been made out to be. All eyes now are on the government.
We will do everything possible to bring the people who are responsible for this to account and throw every penalty that is available to us at them.
On the numbers we've just heard there, though, we're talking about every penalty will be thrown at them. On the numbers we've just heard there, there's $8,000 for the initial act, $800 per head of wildlife would amount to a total fine of $40,000. There's no jail time being suggested. And if this massacre is what it seems to be, there's something desperately wrong.
It's very sad. I mean, the Premier's being very cautious here. I just wonder, you know, there must be some blame here. Somebody must have given a permit to clear that land, whether it be a local council, because you can't clear land without a permit being issued. And it would seem that there's a problem that they haven't factored into the fact that there were so many koalas there.
Mm. Well, yeah, it was legally cleared on private property. Someone's coming after that.
Yeah.
It's just so horrible, especially after the bushfires. You know, we've already seen how the fires were affected. Then to then go and do that seems so heartless.
Well, we'll stay on top of it, see where it goes. Time for a break. More Project.